Let's go cut down a tree. I haven't seen you guys in a while. And I felt like making videos again. I've been talking to one of my friends, and he's very interested in it. So kind of sparked my interest in doing it again. Made me think about how much I miss doing it. So I'm out here at my parents' place. I'm staying out here while I get my business off the ground and can get a place of my own. But coming off the road was kind of a hard change for me, I guess. Trying to figure out what I wanted to do here and just what path I wanted to take, where I wanted to go, and did I actually want to stay off the road and stay around here. But I think I do. So yeah, I've started a pressure washing business. I think I've talked about that before, but that's what I've been working on, is just building clientele and building a customer base. But helping out on my parents' farm in the slow months of winter, you know, when there's not a whole lot to wash. So I still have some accounts that I do. But I got a little bit more free time. Oh, there's a duck in my pond. I wonder if you can see that. There's two ducks, mallard. That's neat. Neat. Yeah, let's go cut down a tree. So we tried to cut into this tree. It's dead. Very, very dead, as you can see. Well, we tried cutting into it, and there was an insulator for an old fence. It's ceramic insulator. And as soon as you hit that, obviously, it died. So we tried pushing it over with our skid steer, but it's still too solid. I think the back side. Backside's got a lot of rot in it. This whole side here is rot. Got a hole here in the middle, probably. Quite a bit of it's hollow, too. But we'll cut into it and see if we can knock it down. It's been a long time since I got a saw stuck, but I sure got it stuck. I didn't think I was anywhere near cutting through it, but again, it's hollow, so I can see it there. So I guess I gotta go grab the skid steer and get it out. Thank you.
I knew that was gonna happen. I was thinking to myself, I'm gonna drop this on my saw as soon as I get it out. I'm gonna get it out of the tree. It's gonna fall on the ground, and then the tree's gonna fall on top of it. Sure enough, I broke the blade lock, so I gotta get a new one of those. Hopefully that's all I broke. Have to take it apart and see. But it is what it is. It is what it is.
Like the right part, don't it? Sweet. Now I just gotta figure out how to take all that crap off. Looks like it'll be easy, right? It's a little muddy out here, to say the least. I don't know if I said this already, but we have like 12 to 16 inches of topsoil and then yellow clay below that, and it's just not very good for nothing. That tree is dead at the top. I don't know, the half of it is. It's got a big old terrible split in it. I don't know if I want to cut that one down, but this one needs to come down. This one's dead.
I'm not afraid to die.
this the other day online, and apparently if you cut a stump like this and you start a fire here, it works like a rocket stove, I guess, where it sucks in air from the sides and burns the stump. Because we tried digging this one out, but it's so far in the ground, you'd need a dozer to get it out of here. Fairly big job to do, and I'm just kind of going through and making sure I've got everything that I need, because I haven't used my trailer a whole lot. I've just been doing some of my weekly accounts, like my truck washing and stuff like that, so occasional house wash or something, or concrete wash, but winter has slowed down quite a bit, so I kind of let my trailer get a little messy. Especially with the antifreeze, because I run antifreeze through my machine to keep it from freezing, you know, in the winter. Because you might use it one day, and it might be 60 degrees one day, like today. And then this weekend, we're supposed to have some snow and stuff. And I might keep my trailer outside. I'm not fancy enough to park it in a heated shop. Maybe someday. But for now, I just run antifreeze. And it takes about 3 gallons, I think, to go through that machine. And to get all in the heater coils and everything and all the way through. It's just a little under 3 gallons, but I run 3 just to be sure, because it's fairly cheap. I think it's like $1.98 a gallon. So just kind of figure that into the cost of the job, that you got to run $6, $7 of antifreeze, which doesn't seem like much, but if you do it, if you have one job a day for a couple weeks, it can add up pretty quick. So... yeah, and then when I do that, usually it's the last thing I do during the day, so there's just empty antifreeze bottles everywhere in here. I've probably got 10 of them right now. So I'm just going through cleaning all of that up, and I've actually got a leak on this, so I'm going to re-silicone it while it's warm today and try and get it to stop squirting out water. I just got this spare tire mount that bolts into the wall, and then it holds your tire. I was tired of it. It's just tired. it was just rolling around on the ground, and my buddy told me he owns a lawn care company where he mows lawns and everything and does landscaping, and he uses one of these, and he's had it on his trailer for a couple years, because I was a little iffy about it, you know, falling off. I mean, there's tubing behind this, but I don't know. It's a lot of bouncing going on back here. But he's had it up for a couple of years, and it seemed to have worked for him. So I'd give it a try. It's got a bolt coming through, and then it's got the lock washer and nut, and then it's got a neoprene washer, a lock nut, whatever they call. Thank you. that's, I mean, it's nice and sucked up to the wall. Should be all right. I don't think that's gonna go anywhere. Isn't that what you say when you strap something down? Okay, that's good for me. My airless sprayer. I don't think I've said anything about that. I haven't really even advertised that a whole lot. I think I did one post or something. This thing I got from Menards as well. Menards is kind of the place to be, but if any of you guys by chance are looking at doing power washing and or staining, definitely get an airless sprayer. I did this one customer, and they wanted the inside of their fence, and they just wanted one side of their fence washed and stained, and I washed it and stained it, and it took me forever. I ended up calling a buddy to come in and help me stain it, because I stained it by hand, and I way undercharged them for what it was, you know, doing it by hand. I'd have been right on with an airless sprayer, but yeah, it took me like 3 hours, 4 hours longer than I expected it to, just because of the sheer time it takes to do it by hand. And I would have done it in, I don't know, maybe 20-30 minutes with this thing. It's amazing, you know. I could do a whole deck, a normal size yard, in our area, it's you know, it's fairly decent size. It's nothing huge, but I could do both sides of the fence in like 2 hours of a privacy, 6 foot privacy fence. I can do both sides in like 2 hours. Of course, that's, you got to come in and wash it, and that takes about an hour and a half to do that, depending on how dirty it is and how much moss is growing, or lichen or whatever growing on it. That lichen's a lot harder to wash off than mold. Yeah, but I can wash and stain a fence in like 4 hours tops. And if I was to do that by hand, it'd take me like 2 days. yeah, so this has definitely been one of my, actually, I wasn't expecting it, but it was one of my biggest money makers this last year. I kind of got into it in the middle of the year, and it just really panned out for me. And yeah, it's really enjoyable too. You know, I would never think that painting is enjoyable or that I love to paint, but staining is just awesome. So this is the way to go. It's Magnum Pro X19 by Graco, whatever you want to say it. I think it's Graco. But yeah, that's the highest model they had at Menards. I think it was like, I got it at the 11% off they do. I want to say it was like $500 or $600. And in the first job, it paid itself off. So first two jobs, really, it paid itself off. At the end of the second job, I was making profit. So, if you guys are thinking about it, definitely go with this. And it's a pretty decent pump for just starting out. And I probably, if I end up getting into this more, this pump's not going to last very long. I might go get a professional pump. This is like the highest residential. But the actual pump on it, to change it or to fix it or anything, you can just pull it off. It takes like 15 seconds. So, even if I have to change it twice a year, I don't know how much they are. I assume not very much, but even if I changed it twice a year, it probably wouldn't be a big deal. But yeah, solid machine. Solid. Super solid. I've got a bunch of different arms for it, so I've got a real long arm so I can stay away from the stain and everything, and it just worked out real well. I actually painted my brother's truck with it, with the same sprayer. And that turned out alright. I'm definitely not a painter. For auto body or automotive or whatever, but just for a matte black finish on a multicolored truck, turned out real nice. I know I've shown you guys this before, but this is the best tool case that I've ever used, portable at least. You know, I've got more tools in my toolbox, but when you have to go do a job or you got to go be out somewhere, you just throw this in your truck. It doesn't take up like any room at all, and it's got just about everything you need to do most things with. Obviously, if you're getting into something big, you're gonna need more tools than this. But with this, excuse me, with this toolkit, I've been able to do just insane things that you never would have thought this thing could do. You know, just because it's so comprehensive, with metric and standard, and then it's got wrenches and quarter inch stuff up here, and it's just Craftsman. So it's a Christmas gift from a long time ago. I almost forgot to say, bye y'all later.